See in practice how simple it is. As they say, you get some tasks on your plate. We'll start with the most frequently worked on ones. You'll definitely have them in lessons about sequences. I mean, we'll start, finish, and at the end I'll show you some slightly more difficult examples. This problem looks very characteristic. The nth root of several numbers raised to the nth power to an infinite power. This is our sequence whose limit we have to calculate. We take it here in the middle, without the limit, because here we are bounding the sequence itself, not the limit of the sequence. So you take the same sequence, rewrite it, bound it from above, bound it from below. And how? From above, you limit it with this sequence, also the nth root, and each constant here, no matter how many there are three, you choose the largest of these numbers, from 3, from 4, from 5, you choose the largest. It's 5. And each of these constants in this upper bounding sequence, you replace with the largest one to the nth power. So instead of 3 to the nth power, I write 5 to the nth power, instead of 4 to the nth power, 5 to the nth power, and I rewrite 5 to the nth power as 5 to the nth power. We agree that this will always be greater than that, right? Logical. This is always a larger number than that, no matter what n we set. So it's a true inequality that this is always greater than or equal to that. And from below, what do you think we limit it with? Not the smallest, but something like this. You still choose the largest, which is 5 to the nth power, and you write it only once. No matter how many constants there are, you only write it once here. The nth root of 5 to the nth power. And we also agree that this is always smaller than that, right? Because this still has 3 to the nth power plus 4 to the nth power. So this is also a true inequality, it's obvious. Now we calculate the limit of the one from below, the limit of the one from above, and show that they are the same. The one from below, because it's easier. The nth root of 5 to the nth power, well, the n and n cancel out here. You can understand it as the nth root being something to the power of 1 over n, and the n is cancel out. Anyway, the cube root of 5 cubed would be 5. The fourth root of 5 to the fourth would be 5. And the nth root of 5 to the nth is exactly 5. And that's it. You don't need to specifically calculate this limit here. So the limit from below turned out to be 5. You are calculating the limit from above. So it will be like this. Now look. Something plus something plus something is 3 times that something. Do we agree? Apple plus apple plus apple is 3 times that apple. If there were 4 of these added, you would write 4 times that something. So we have something like this. This step is clear. Now, the nth root of something times something is the nth root of the first thing times the nth root of the second thing. So it will be something like this. Regarding the first one, we know that the nth root here cancels out with the n, and the first part approaches 5. And for the second one, well, this is actually the first time we need a formula. We need a formula for the nth root of any number, which is 1. You can understand it this way, it's 3 to the power of 1 over n. As n approaches infinity, 1 over n approaches 0. So 3 to the power of 0 is 1. Or take a calculator, take any number, even a very large one, and keep taking the root of the root of the root of the root. You keep tapping your finger on the root button, and you'll see that sooner or later, it will end up on your calculator with only 1 remaining, no matter what number you start this game with. So our result will be, this approaches 1, that approaches 5, so 1 times 5, which is 5. The moral of the story is that if the lower one approaches 5, the upper one approaches 5. Actually, no, that's not the moral, those are the assumptions. And the moral of the story is 31 in the middle also approaches 5. And now look, super important, you need to write a nice answer to the professor, meaning you need to write why this limit is 5 in the first place. So you write, by the squeeze theorem, this limit that you need to calculate equals 5. Definitely. Or somehow else, from the squeeze theorem or something, you show the professor that you know what's going on, and not that you are just doing it mechanically. And that's it, that's the whole method of the squeeze theorem. Simple, very simple, very schematic.